Welcome to Mastering Cloud Threats with Microsoft Defender for Cloud and Defender XDR Integration. I am Parul, Senior Product Marketing Manager, leading server and container security with Defender for Cloud. Today, we're going to walk you through the concept of cloud detection and response, Microsoft's solution towards cloud detection and response, some of the latest releases that we had in the past couple of months, and the most part of this presentation, we're going to focus on a demonstration showcasing you how Microsoft protects your environment in runtime. And lastly, we're going to end it up with some of the resources that you could dive in to learn more about CDR with Microsoft. So let's begin. CDR as a concept is not new to the world. Cloud attacks are growing, but they're not only growing, they're evolving. And traditional security measures are being outstripped. Organizations are investing in preventive measures such as vulnerability management, runtime protection. But these tools alone are not enough to protect your environment from these sophisticated threats. What you need is correlated data from all your workloads in your environment, and CDR helps empower your security operations center, that's your SOC team, to really give additional context, insight, investigation, and real-time detection and response. The way CDR works is you're going to get your threat signals. CDR is going to detect them, investigate them, and provide you with real-time insights and response actions. Now, if all of that was not enough as benefits to CDR, I have these five pointers with me on the slide that you can see. Starting with, CDR gives you a comprehensive visibility end-to-end of all your data points and workloads in your environment. Second, because it's a real-time detection and response, your response time increases by many folds. So if traditional security measures are giving you 30 minutes of a response time, CDR helps you in a couple of minutes. So your SOC teams are efficient and better. Third, with the traditional or conventional methods, your SOC teams are thrown away with ginormous amount of alerts. Some of them are duplicated. Some of them are repetitive. Some of them are not even critical. CDR helps tackle alert fatigue and provides you everything that is critical and most important to your environment. So your SOC teams are better equipped. Fourth, because CDR provides you with in-time detection, in-depth investigation, and efficient response mechanism, it helps contain and curb the incidents, security incidents, well in time so as to avoid lateral movement from your environment to maybe multi-cloud environment. So the lateral movement is quite low with the help of CDR. And lastly, and most importantly, CDR is cloud native. That means it's purpose built for your cloud environment and to understand the threats pertaining to your cloud environment. So, CDR as a concept gives you a unified view of your workloads end-to-end in your cloud environment, helps you detect, investigate, and respond to these security incidents well in time, and better empowers and equips your SOC team. So let's talk about Microsoft's three-pronged approach to CDR. There are three pillars that we focus on. Spot, that means detect the threat signals, investigate or analyze those threat signals to understand where they're coming from. Third and last is provide you with real-time response action. Let's dive a little bit deep into all three of these. First was cloud-native threat detection. Now, Microsoft's solution really detects Kubernetes stacks with the help of eBPF sensor powered by Microsoft Defender Endpoint Agent. What that really means is it empowers you to monitor your hosts and cluster through agentless malware detection and Kubernetes audit logs. It also specializes in containerized environment, which means that your container images need to be immutable, right? So once they're not, and there is a drift, a binary drift, CDR is able to quickly catch that drift so that your security teams or your SOC is empowered and enriched with data. Second was in-depth investigation. Now, whenever there's a threat signal, you really want to understand where that is coming from. What is the root cause of that threat signal? And with our solution in CDR, we provide you with threat analytics report, which again specializes in containerized environment, but it tells you the attack method that was used to infiltrate your environment, the attack type or the threat type that was there, so that you're better equipped and you understand which resources to go back to. And last but not the least, in-time, real-time response action. With Microsoft's solution, the unauthorized access to a compromised pod is manually terminated or isolated from your system. We are also providing you with AI-guided or AI-powered remediation so that you could act fast and respond faster and cut these incidents running into breaches. And with that, we want to show you that Microsoft offers protection to your runtime environment, provides you with cloud-native threat detection, gives you in-depth investigation and real-time response action so your SOC teams are able to do their jobs in the best way possible. Now, what you see on your screen are some of the latest releases that we had in CDR. I wouldn't spend too much time on this, but some of these are around binary drift detection, AI-powered guided remediation, process alerts, response actions, and process events and investigation queries. We do have additional resources that talk about these latest releases in depth, so definitely go check them out. And now, as I said earlier, we're gonna spend the most amount of time demonstrating all these capabilities and helping you understand how can you really protect your runtime environment. So let's begin. So we're gonna start with Defender portal, Defender XDR portal. And that's because that's where your SOC teams sit. This is exactly where your SOC teams feel most comfortable with. We wanted to make sure that your SOC doesn't move from one portal to another portal. So we've had Microsoft Defender for Cloud integrate with Defender XDR, and you'll see how fabulously that works. So we start off with investigation and response, and we have some incidents and alerts for you. You'll see all the incidents in your environment that are happening at the moment. So when we filter this out, I want to take a minute here and show you that even though we're focusing on Microsoft Defender for Cloud right now, what you see on your screen are all the security products that are there, which means that your data is actually correlated from all these products in your environment, so you get a comprehensive view of what's happening in your runtime environment. Now, for the purposes of this demo, we're gonna focus on Defender for Cloud, and we're gonna show you a containerized environment and how we protect that. So let's focus on one of the incidents that has high severity vulnerability in it. So when we click on that, on the top, you'll notice that there is a critical asset marking in this incident, which only means that this incident consists of one critical asset that you really need to focus on. Another way of looking at it is on the right, you have the incident graph that has a crown on one of the assets. That's also your marking showing you that this asset, it is critical in your environment. So your SOC teams are better equipped to know that, okay, hey, this incident is important to me because it has a critical asset. So when you click on the player attack story, you'll see all the alerts start showing up and all the latest ones will show up right at the top. You'll click and exit play mode and it'll stop showing it to you. But I want to focus on a couple of alerts that you can see just to show you the diversity. So you'll see one of the Kubernetes API requests. That's one of the alerts that we have here. Then there's also a suspicious invocation of a high credential access. But what I really want to focus on is the brute force attempt that was actually made on an AWS RDS resource. I want to showcase this to you in order to show that our solution is not only Azure native, but we also focus on and get data or correlate data from other multi-cloud environments. And clearly you can see here, there was a brute force attempt that was made on an AWS resource. So it's not only just us, but we also make sure that data is collected from all the multi-cloud environment in your system. Now, when we click on that, I also want to showcase what I was mentioning earlier was the attack method or attack paths. So when you click on this, you're going to see a lot of attack paths. And what it really does is it tells you how an infiltrator entered in your system and what was the target that they wanted to actually, you know, extract sensitive information from. So in one of the incident, the attack methods here, the infiltrator actually captured a container image, and using its authorization access, it wanted to get to a storage account that actually had sensitive information. So this attack path really helps you understand how an attacker is going to move into your system. So this is one of the examples of that. Let's move ahead and look at another incident. So we'll go through again the attack story. We exit that. And there is one incident that I want to focus on, and that's the binary drift detection. And I know I briefly mentioned it earlier, but container images are immutable. That means that the way they originated, they are supposed to be the same way in your runtime environment. If an executable runs in a container image, that means that it has changed. That means there is a binary drift that happens. And this alert that you see here actually shows exactly that. So when I click on it, you'll actually know what's exactly happening with binary drift detection. And now the next step would be to actually investigate on these alerts, right? And I'm going to hand it over to my colleague, Dick Lake, who's going to walk you through the investigation piece of our solution and then the response actions.
Okay, so my name is Dick Lake, and I'm going to walk you through the rest of this investigative process for this container resource. And one of the first things that I want to point out is the Threat Analytics Overview Report. We build these for you to establish a common level of understanding about a particular technology group. So for example, I know databases extremely well. However, I am by no means a subject matter expert when it comes to container security. And so in order to get me caught up, I can go to the Threat Analytics Report and quickly get a nice executive summary over what's going on. What are the common attacks? What are the typical targets? And if we scroll down through this, this report, we'll see examples of queries that can be taken and run in an advanced hunting context. And we'll show that a bit later. Now, if we go back to our incident, we mentioned that one of the key things is how do we actually respond to events? And so we're going to take some actions here on our Kubernetes cluster. So we can click into the cluster and we can see Go Hunt. And if we expand that open, we can run a query that shows us all the activity in the past 24 days. So if we want to step in further, click. We can use the advanced hunting tables that Microsoft has provided to really take a look at the cloud audit and cloud process events. So if we scroll down, we'll see cloud infrastructure. And so cloud process events are those data plane events that are coming off of your Kubernetes clusters. So here we're going to look past through the past 7 days, looking for container instances that have used either nmap or zgrab, which is a common attack. Alternatively, we can use the cloud audit events to do the same thing, looking back to see at the control plane level what's been going on. So we've gone back to our incident, and now I want to show our integration with Security Copilot. So when we open it up, we can see the summary that Security Copilot generates for us, which is great because this attack story actually involved about 24 different alerts. And that can be really hard to wrap your head around. But it's also going to give us some actions that we can take. Since this is a container workload, we can actually begin to terminate the pod completely, or we can just isolate it from the network. And obviously, if we're taking these response actions, we're going to need to be able to do it both automatically and manually, but also show how and what happened. And so this time we go to the pod and we see our actions. And we have our two options to either isolate the pod or to terminate the pod. And so here we're going to isolate the pod and we'll provide a comment that will help us understand why are we doing this. And we'll click confirm. But if we go over to our action center, we can switch over to the history and begin to see all of the different automated responses that we've taken. So whether it's to isolate or to terminate. And if it's to isolate, we can actually complete our investigation and then release it from isolation.
So as promised, these are some of the resources that you could leverage and dive deep into Microsoft's solution for cloud detection and response. We released many, many new innovations in the last couple of months. There is an amazing blog that you could reference to. That's the first asset that you should leverage. That would give you all the posture-related innovations and threat protection-related innovations, especially in containerized environment for Microsoft Defender for Cloud. Second that we have is a video. It's a YouTube video that you could use to understand the concept holistically and how Microsoft really delivers on the cloud detection and response. Third is a very interesting tool that we have developed just for you. So it's a simulator tool which you could actually use to leverage these innovations, but in your environment. With the help of the simulator tool, you could actually understand how these latest innovations would help you protect your runtime environment. So an interesting tool, definitely make use of that. And there's another blog that's coming up in the first week of May, and that's all about CDR as a concept. How do we differentiate it from the runtime protection concept? And then how Microsoft is doing its bit to provide your SOC the best CDR solution possible.